he doing? I got here as fast as I could.
It's right. It's too late, Rick. He's dead. Pop's dead.
Hang on a minute there. Are you trying to tell me that Cass is the one that hurt you?
Oh, please don't be angry with her, Jude, but it was Cass who tried to kill me. She didn't mean to do it. I mean, heavens, when I spoke to her about it, she didn't even remember.
Pixie, are you absolutely sure of this?
Of course I am. Well, at first I thought I was going mad because, you see, she didn't know it was me. And then she said something, I'm not quite sure what, but she thought I was Bobby. And I didn't understand that, Jude, because Bobby is Cass's friend. And, well, why would Cass want to kill Bobby? It just doesn't make sense.
Yes, it makes a lot of sense. God, I hope we're not too late.
Continued notes on subject number 3, Margaret Morris. This case is working better than expected. I must take all necessary steps to ensure I'm not held responsible for her dramatic personality reversal.
How'd you go with Reno?
Where's Bobby?
Gone to the loo. I think she's got a Japanese bladder.
Yeah, need a dumbo to hold her hand.
Did Cass go with her?
What's wrong?
Answer me,
yes.
Quick! Now, you get a screw. We need help. We gotta stop Cass.
Jude?
Fancy bumping into you. You all right?
You don't fool me, Bobby.
What are you talking about?
You're gonna get what's coming to you.
Come on, Cass, stop mucking around.
I've got to kill you. Stop, you hurting people.
But I thought you were my mate. What have I done?
Don't try and calm me. I know what you're up to. I've got to kill you before you kill me. Stop you hurting all the others, too.
But I wouldn't!
Cass! You fucking mongrel!
No, Cass! Cass!
No, it's all right, Jude. I've got it.
Cass, for God's sake, you don't like hurting people, do you? Hey, why don't you just give me those scissors?
Oh, no, you don't understand, Jude. I've got to do this or she's going to kill us all.
No, I do understand. I do, but you've got the wrong person. Yeah, that's not Bobby. I know that. I just saw Bobby in the laundry.
Oh, what are you talking about, Judy? This is Bobby.
No, it's not. You made a mistake. Just like the one you made with Pixie.
Yes, you thought I was Bobby, remember?
This is Bobby.
No, it's not.
I'm new here, Cass.
This is Sue from Maternity Cass. She gets back to herself, Pixie. Hey, don't worry, I'll help you find Bobby.
Yeah, thanks, Jude. Don't know how I came to make such a mistake.
Yeah, never mind that. How about I look after the scissors?
Oh, no. Oh, no, I've got to do it.
Sure, you keep them. Well, we better go and look for Bobby, hey?
Yeah. I've got to kill her today or we'll all be dead.
Well, let's get started, huh?
Yeah.
I hope we're not too late. Just calm down. Amazing, isn't it? When you want a screw, you can never find one. Hey, Cass, how are you?
Okay, now what's the big emergency?
No big worries, Mrs. Powell, we'll handle it.
That's right, we're just looking for Bobby. See, Cass has to kill Bobby because if Cass doesn't kill Bobby, Bobby will kill us.
Yeah. No one's going to be safe till Bobby's dead, Mrs. Powell.
What is happening? I think Edmonds has screwed her up with hypnosis.
Bastard!
Parker! If you want Mitchell, she's up in isolation.
No worries, I'll find her.
Well, why don't I come with you? Just in case she gives you some trouble. I think you better give me the scissors, though.
Anna.
Hey, come on. You don't want Miss Ferguson to catch you with them, do you? I'll give them back as soon as we've found Mitchell.
Okay.
Why don't you let some of the others know where we've gone? Just in case Mitchell does give us trouble.
Right.
Okay, come on.
Give me 5 minutes with that mongrel.
Subject has no memory or knowledge of recent uncharacteristic behavior. End of case. I will now test the theory that after achieving desirable behavior through hypnosis, the reverse can be achieved.
I see you found some of my boring tapes. I've only heard one so far, and it was far from boring.
Don't you think you should hear what I have to say before you go?
I think I've heard enough.
With no background knowledge of psychology and without the benefit of my written notes, you could be way off the mark. Don't you realise that?
I don't need a psychology degree to hear you say you used hypnosis on Meg, obviously without her knowledge or anyone else's.
Anne, can't you understand the scientific importance of my work? Can't you see what I'm trying to achieve?
I know what you did to Meg, John, and it's unforgivable. You lied to me and you lied to the department. And I'm quite sure Mrs. Davidson will see the sense of removing you and your program from Wentworth.
Anne.
John, there is nothing you can say that'll make me change my mind, so please.
You're upset at the moment, and you're making a mountain out of a molehill. Can't you see?
I'm sure Meg would be flattered to know that the manipulation of her life was no more than a molehill to you.
I only use hypnotherapy to help her with her insomnia. She proved to be very susceptible to my methods.
So I heard on your tape.
It's not what you're thinking, Anne. I just got carried away by my scientific curiosity and decided to try a small personality reversal.
Small? My God, what an understatement. I hope you never get into nuclear physics. You'd convince yourself the Big Bang was nothing but a ping-pong game.
The effect was temporary and she came to no harm.
No thanks to you. I wonder what little gems of behavioural modification you've managed with the prisoners you've worked with.
You don't have to worry on that score, I promise you. And if you report this to the department, it'll mean years of valuable research down the drain.
John, I would love to believe that this is no more than an error of judgment on your part, but I can't. I've been in touch with the Foxsmith Institute, and I know why you were asked to leave.
Foxsmith Institute? They understood nothing of my methods or my achievements. It was hopeless trying to get through to them.
It sounds almost paranoid. John, even if I approved of what you've done, I couldn't allow you to go on using the women or my officers as guinea pigs.
You just won't let us.
Mrs. Reynolds, Parker just went after Mitchell with a pair of scissors.
How's Mitchell?
Well, she's very upset, but not actually hurt.
And Parker?
Well, Mrs. Powell has put her in isolation.
It's unusual for Parker to lose her temper with her friends.
I know, that's the funny part about it. She's quite calm, just insists that she must save everyone from Mitchell.
I'll be right there.
Right.
I'll be in your office after I've seen Parker. I have the feeling you've got a lot more to answer for yet.
Bobby, you've just had a very nasty fright. You'll be okay. There.
Thought she had me pigs.
Yeah.
She just kept standing over me with them scissors. Oh, honey, are you okay? I would have been a goner if you hadn't come along, Jude. Cass must really hate me.
No, she doesn't. Truly, she didn't know what she was doing.
She knew, all right. She was just staring at me as though I was a real animal.
It's just not true, love. Look, we don't know this for sure, but we think that Dr. Edmonds hypnotized her. Made her feel that she had to get you before you got us all.
No, Quack couldn't make you do something you didn't want to do.
Yes.
Kaz must hate me.
No.
Oh. What are we going to do, Jude? She's had so many nasty frights. No wonder she's sick.
My God, how did you think you could get away with it?
With what?
Parker. You actually programmed her to kill Mitchell, didn't you?
Rubbish! I can't be held responsible for Parker's temper. I told you it's uncontrollable. I tried.
Oh, you tried? By concentrating all her aggression against her best friend.
I used hypnotherapy to turn her against someone she cared for. It was an experiment.
What a self-important, callous bastard you are.
Well, there's no room for sentiment in scientific research. The results are all that matters.
What about people? What about Parker and Mitchell? Are they nothing to you?
If scientists allowed themselves to be governed by emotions, we'd be back in the Stone Age.
Is that what you would have put on Mitchell's headstone if Parker had killed her?
Mitchell was expendable. The girl's a criminal, costing the community money every day she's here. Through my experiments, at least she fulfills some useful function.
I see. I hope you'll be able to explain your reasons as clearly as that to the police.
Why the police?
There is no way I'm going to stand by and see Parker blamed for what she tried to do to Mitchell.
Anne, you realize you'd be throwing away any chance we had of a future together?
I think you've already done that.
Yes. Well, I suppose that's it.
Not quite. You've got one more task before you leave. You're going to reverse whatever it was you did to Parker. And I'm going to be watching to make sure you do.
So, from what we can make out, Dr. Edmonds was using hypnosis to change people's basic personalities.
Changed Cass, all right.
Does that mean I was hypnotized too?
Yeah, you've been in a trance all your life.
It would have had to have been, love. Otherwise, why would you have thrown away your wedding photos?
Ah, that's a load of bull. Hypnosis can't do that to you.
Oh, really? What about your sugar and spice act then?
Oh, you got to admit, that was a nice change.
Oh, God, you love a thick. I was just going along with him for the kicks.
Oh. Well, you must be stronger in the mind than I am, Phyllis. I couldn't remember a thing about it.
Everybody's stronger in the mind than you are.
Don't be rude.
She's just jealous, love.
Listen. You nongs think I'm stupid, don't you? I was getting free smokes and days off work and a real kick out of watching you lot think I'd turn soft.
Yeah, well, I'll go along with Phyllis. I reckon if she was faking it, Cass was too. She just wanted everyone to think she was hypnotized so she could do Bobby in and get away with it.
You know, you're a real bitch, Keen. Why would Cass want to hurt Bobby?
I can think of a dozen reasons. How about Donovan and Manning, for starters? Anyway, that nutloaf wouldn't need a reason. Probably in a straitjacket by now.
Shut up, Keen. Love, don't listen to her. You know Cass wouldn't hurt you deliberately.
She's always been your friend. You made a mistake. Cass, you were wrong to try and kill Bobby. There's no reason to hurt Bobby. She is your friend.
No reason to hurt Bobby. My friend.
She could hang for what he did to Pop.
I understand how you feel. But don't let that guy screw you. Look, I know I've been there. And once that hate gets into you, just never get rid of it. And I won't bring him back.
But why, Pop? It's not fair. It's just not fair.
Just let it out. Come on, look, if you want to cry, you cry. Don't hold it back.
I can't, Rick. I'm just numb. You know I love Pop more than anything else in the world. But I can't cry.
Are you trying to tell me you didn't set up Parker to have a go at that other girl?
Exactly. I had no idea she'd react so violently. I was only interested in the psychological effect of turning a person against a friend.
Yes, but you knew you were dealing with a woman that had a record of violence, didn't you?
Ah, yes, but I hoped that my treatment would remove her repressed anger by channeling it in one direction, you see. It's an experimental technique.
Sounds like the methods I used in Korea and NAM, only we called it brainwashing.
Something like that. But those techniques took months of programming. With my system, after the initial assessment, the same results can be achieved in a matter of minutes.
Great. Fantastic.
Oh, yes, it's a major breakthrough. And I'm sure you can see the possibilities of reforming the criminal mind.
Yes, well, we'll be listening to your tape so we know exactly what your new breakthrough's all about.
Just one tape. The one Mrs. Reynolds was listening to.
And that doesn't agree with her statement.
Then I'm afraid she's mistaken. I've only ever used one tape for my notes. Then I record over it as necessary.
What's that like?
From the doc's office. Some notes and a cassette.
Well, you only had to ask. I'd have given them to you. After all, I've got nothing to hide.
Well, then you won't mind coming down the station to make a formal statement, will you? Just routine, of course.
No problem.
Anything you want from your office?
No, of course not. After you, gentlemen.
Ah, oh, lucky you. It's been quite a day, hasn't it? Is Parker all right now?
Yes, thank God.
I really didn't hear too much about it. What actually happened?
I'll have to tell you tomorrow. I've got to get to the real estate office. Something's come up about the sale of the house.
Oh, dear, I do hope they haven't pulled out.
Oh, thanks, Joyce. Good night.
Oh, I didn't mean that. Oh, Dr. Edmonds. Oh, is there any message for Mrs. Reynolds?
No, I'll be back soon.
Oh, well, Doctor, you'll probably be needing this.
No thanks, Mrs. Barry. Just keep it here till I get back.
Oh, right.
I don't know. Perhaps we'd better take it along. I'm sure the doctor won't mind us examining the contents. Will you?
No. No, of course not.
I've had some crook tucker in this place in me time, but that's going to be the worst ever. Useless damn thing. Hey, about time we got the show back on the road, don't you think? Hmm? Business, Phil. There's money to be made.
Yeah, well, you better wait till this stuff with the shrink dies down. Everyone's a bit towy at the moment.
Well, the better for us if their minds are on other things. Uh-oh, Dumbo's back.
Yeah, fancy letting a shrink stuff you up like that.
You can't kid me. He really had you going.
Rubbish, he did.
You have to eat something, Bobby, or you're going to be ill.
Yeah, I'd only chuck it all in.
Oh, look, it's all right, Bobby.
Yeah, she's just come in to finish you off.
Shut up, Ace Weasel, or I'll shut it for you.
Bobby, I'm sorry.
Bobby. Oh,
Cass, don't let it get to you, love. She's had a bit of a shock, that's all.
Just wanted to tell her I didn't mean it, Myra. I didn't want to hurt her.
Honey, we know that. It's just going to take time, that's all.
We'll have to do something to put it right.
Yeah, get yourself committed.
Don't pay any attention to that lot.
Maybe she's got something.
Mrs. Powell's here, Mr. Heineman.
Well, this is a surprise. Please, sit down. So, what brings you to this neck of the woods? Decided to invest after all?
Just a minute, I think we've got our wires crossed. Your receptionist phone said that you wanted to see me.
Oh, boy. Actually, what I asked her to do was call you and give you the good news.
Well, I'm glad it's good news anyway.
I am sorry. She's had one hell of a day, though, so we'll forgive her this one, eh?
Yes, all right. Please don't keep me in suspense.
Yes, indeed. Well, you might as well see for yourself. The Webbs decided to settle in cash. That's the balance.
$63,000. Yeah, this is mine now.
Yeah, not quite. Now, the check's made out to our trust account. I'll get it round to your solicitors as soon as possible. They can do the necessaries. Then it's yours.
Well, I can't believe it. All this time I've just been thinking of selling the house. Money I didn't.
I can't change your mind about investing in more property, can I?
No, no. Well, not yet anyway. I think you're just going to have to give me time to get used to things first.
Hey, you should fill it again. What are you up to?
I'm getting this ready for Jack. I don't want to be running out of things midweek.
Why don't you leave the shop shut, at least till after the funeral? Customers will understand. You let it out, honey. You just let it all out.
He's really gone, isn't he? Stay with me tonight.
Thank you.
on the rack all night.
That'll teach you to play volleyball. Let's see what Pixie was up to last night. Yes.
Judy, Myra, did Mrs. Myers tell you about Cass?
What happened?
She tried to kill herself last night. It was all there's blood everywhere.
Mrs. M, Cass, how is she?
She's all right. She cut her wrist, but fortunately the cuts weren't very deep. Come on, get a move on.
Oh, thank goodness she's all right.
Oh, hurry up.
I was so frightened. I mean, I honestly thought she'd die.
Thank God you were in that room, huh?
Yeah.
If I didn't know better, I'd say you tied one on last night.
Wish I had. I feel bloody awful.
You're probably coming down with something.
Oh, what do you know? Mitchell's got morning sickness.
Rack off, Phyllis.
Come on, let's go somewhere where the air's clean.
I'm sick and tired of your wisecracks, Weasel.
Where's your sense of humour?
You don't make jokes like that where Bobby's concerned.
So what if she got pregnant in Sydney? Who cares?
Fly off.
Now, I want you to get this through your thick head. Some doctor has told Bobby that she can never have children and it damn near killed her. Have you got it? I said, have you got it?
Yeah, yeah,
hey,
I got it.
What's going on?
Phyllis had something in her eye, Mrs. M. But I fixed it.
Morning. Is it?
Uh-oh. What's happened?
Parker attempted suicide last night.
Oh, my God.
No real harm done, from what I can gather. Physically, anyway.
Edmund should be shot.
Or worse. Also, Geldschmidt had a hearing yesterday.
Now go.
She's being deported tomorrow.
And there's no hopes of a last-minute appeal. Look, my timing might be lousy, but can I have a word with you?
Something cheerful, I hope.
Will I? Suppose that depends on how you look at it.
I'm intrigued. Come on.
Ta.
You're as stubborn as a mule, aren't you?
I have to do something to keep busy, Rick. Go crazy sitting around doing nothing. Besides, Pop never missed a day in his life. I owe it to him to keep the shop open.
Yeah, well, I haven't got time to argue with you. Better get to work.
Good. You talk too much anyway.
I better give you a lift home after work.
Listen, you mustn't feel you have to keep running round after me the whole time.
I don't feel I'm running round. Just give you a lift home after work.
Thanks.
Don't work too hard.
When Mrs. Morris turned her torch on, I nearly fainted. Well, there was simply blood everywhere. I didn't think there'd be a drop left in her.
Pixie, give it a miss, will you?
Oh, Bobby, are you okay?
Just a bit queasy.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bobby. I won't mention blood anymore.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Good idea, Pixie. Now, where's all your ideas for making money in our rec time?
Oh, well, I thought I could start sewing things like cushion covers and dresses for bride stalls and things like that.
Well, no wonder we're behind with our quota. Come on, less chat and more work. You too, Parker. A little light duties will keep you out of mischief. And Desmond, the governor wants to see you.
Yes.
Don't you ever do that again, Cass Parker.
Well, that was the stupidest thing you ever did, huh?
I reckon it's the first time I've shown any nous.
Cass, you could have died.
I thought that was the idea.
You were just so pale. I didn't think you'd have a drop of blood in you. There was just blood everywhere.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bobby. I didn't mean to.
Just go and get a spell.
I didn't mean to mention blood.
Bobby, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry, Bobby. Jeez, I'm a mongrel. That's where I am.
If it wasn't for bad luck, Cass wouldn't have any luck at all, would she?
Mitchell doesn't seem to have got over her attack either. Hasn't been a very good week, has it?
No.
How's Rachel?
Taking it pretty hard. Pop was the only family she had. I don't know what to do.
You really care about her, don't you?
Yeah, I do, a lot. It's just...
Well, you just don't know whether you're in love with her or not.
No, no. Well, George dying like that, I just feel like I've been thrown in the deep end or something. I don't know.
Well, why don't you just look at it as helping a friend through a very difficult time? Just let the rest happen.
Looking for holes in new socks, you
reckon? Yeah, something like that.
Thanks. Well, move on. Oops, sorry.
My pleasure.
Well, you look as though you've just won the lottery.
Close.
Oh, come on, tell me. Don't keep me in suspense.
I've just handed in my resignation. Paris, Rome, the Greek islands. I am going to see as much of the world as I possibly can. What do you think?
I'm too stunned to think.
So was Anne.
How on earth did you get her to agree to 48 hours' notice?
I've no idea, but I'm glad she did. Now, just a minute, I haven't finished yet. I want you to come with me.
Oh, God, I think you'd better speak to my bank manager.
No. All the fares will be on me. It's my way of saying thanks for everything you've done for me.
Oh, God's sake, don't be ridiculous.
Why not? We could have a ball.
You're serious, aren't you?
Yes.
Colleen, it is a wonderful, kind, generous offer, but I couldn't possibly take you up on it.
Why not? You're due for long service leave, aren't you?
Yes.
There you go. You've got the time. I've got money. It's simple. I know I'm behaving irrationally, but I don't care. It's just something I feel I've got to do. All my life, I've had to worry about money. I've had to plan for the future. Even this trip. Pat and I had planned that before we married. So now it's just one day at a time. Well, come on. Are you going to be my travelling companion or not?
Oh, you know I'd love to, but...
We could be in London this time next week. Where's your sense of adventure, girl?
Oh, at the back of a drawer somewhere,
then
I think.
Then find it.
Oh, Colleen, you've just got to give me time to think.
All right. I'll let you think about it.
Come on, Cash, you've got to stop giving yourself such a hard time. Bobby probably really does have the flu.
I tried to kill her, Jude. Only natural she'd feel off whenever I was around. Reckon I made a mistake being born.
You said
it. Oh, stop that, Phyllis. Can't you see she's very depressed?
Oh, sorry.
Look, she's in hospital, isn't she? The doctors are looking after her. They'll find out what's wrong with her and she'll be back with us in no time.
You think so?
I know so.
Hannah's being deported.
Oh, no. Said we never get good news around here.
For God's sake, why?
Because of her West German passport. They'll only accept refugees from communist countries. I mean, the fact that she escaped from one doesn't seem to make any difference. Her passport says she's from West Germany.
I don't know what you're grizzling about. I reckon they're doing us a favour.
You'll do me a favour by butting out.
Oh, that's not fair. Hannah told me she sold everything she owned to get that passport.
Well, couldn't she appeal? I mean, what about her relatives?
Well, this Werner bloke reckons that if they come forward, she could be granted residency. But, I mean, by the time that happens, she'll probably be back in Germany.
Oh, red tape. Don't you love it?
Anyway, there is some good news. We have our first open day next weekend.
Hey, good one.
And I asked Mrs. Reynolds if we could make it a fete.
That's wonderful, man.
Oh, we can have stores and decorations and everything.
Yeah. We used to have fetes when I was in the Girl Guides, you know, raise money for our trips and stuff.
Yeah. Well, I don't know what we can sell, but I'm sure we'll think of something.
Well, we don't have much time, so we'd better get ourselves organised.
Right.
Bought you some more.
Oh, good, thanks. Just pop them on the desk. You've been speaking to Colleen this morning.
Yes, talk about a bombshell. I've never seen her quite so excited.
Understandable. I've been avoiding it, but I think we ought to have a talk about Jonathan.
Yes, sir. I suppose we should.
From what Colleen's told me, I'm not the only one to have had the wool pulled over my eyes.
And I had no idea you were seeing him.
Oh, likewise. He made quite sure of that.
I feel so stupid about it. I mean, to have been taken in like that.
Well, how do you think I feel? I fell for the man 25 years ago. I of all people should have known better.
Anne, I'm so sorry.
I'm just glad for your sake the whole thing came to light when it did.
Well, for both our sakes, surely.
Well, whatever Jonathan Edmonds has done, he did do me some good in a way. I'd managed to convince myself that the surgeon had removed my femininity when he removed that breast, and, it's crazy, I know, but... my little fling stopped me feeling that way.
Has he been charged?
And not before time. Attempting to incite murder.
Good. Well, he's left quite a trail of destruction behind him. It'll take Parker some time to get over this, and Mitchell too, no doubt.
I was afraid he might have destroyed our friendship too. Glad he hasn't, Meg.
Miss Cass, it's not like her to be late.
No idea. She said she had to see someone and took off.
You never believe what I just heard.
Tries.
Well, Mr. Manning and Mrs. O'Shea were talking in the corridor, and Mr. Manning said that Mrs. Powell has resigned.
Are you sure?
Of course I am. Gosh, I'm starving.
Talk about a stroke of luck. This fate is just what we need.
Where's that?
Screws will let us bring things in from the outside. Plasticine, finger paint, cocaine, mandrax.
Have you heard the news?
Rack off.
Well, I just thought you'd like to know what I just heard.
You heard, Nick off.
Oh, all right, if you don't want to know.
You realise they're going to have to get a new deputy governor.
You can bet your boots the freak will be the first to apply.
A lovely turn of events.
We're going to have to stop her getting it, aren't we?
Oh, you mean Bobby has got the flu?
No, love. The freak has got high hopes.
Oh, just want to see her. Just for a minute, just to tell her I'm sorry. Can't I see her just for a minute?
I'm sorry, Cass. Bobby's had a terrible shock. She needs time to get over it. Let her come to you when she's ready.
How could I let him do that to me, Mrs. Reynolds?
You've got no choice, Cass. That's why Dr. Edmonds will be punished for what he did.
I'm the one who ought to be punished. I tried to kill her.
Now, come on. Don't you think you've punished yourself enough?
Miss Reynolds, she won't even talk to me.
Yes, can I help you? What do you want?
I heard that he'd passed on, I'm sorry. I'd like to help with the expenses, the funeral costs, it seems...
I don't want your money. Now get out.
Be reasonable, Miss Milsom. There was nothing I could do, you know that.
You could have taken a taxi. You were too drunk to walk, let alone drive.
That's a lie! Look, you saw it. He stepped out in front of me. I couldn't stop. If you say that in court, I'll pay all the expenses, whatever you like.
I'll say whatever I have to say to make sure they put you behind bars, Mr. Priest.
All right. Fine. I'll just have to say that the silly old bastard stepped out in front of me, Your Honor.
Get out! Get out of this shop!
I mean, West Germany is a free country, just like Australia.
My husband is political prison.
Yes, but you're away from all of that now. They can't get you anymore.
They get me, Judy. I escape. They get me for that. I will have accident, you see? I'd rather die here in Australia.
Oh, poor Hannah. I wish we could do something.
Now, there you go, Hannah. Here's a clean one.
Thank you, Cass. What is this?
Well, I hurt him a little bit, that's all. Watch the telly now.
She's feeling a bit low, love. Silly thing cut her wrists.
To kill herself?
Here, you're leaving?
Yeah. Sorry, I was going to tell you.
Oh, it's all right. I know how busy you can be. I'll be sorry to see you go, of course.
Of course.
Naturally, I applied for the deputy governor's job as soon as Mrs. Reynolds told me.
Thought you might.
Well, there was no hurry. After all, I'm the logical choice.
Well, if there's one thing guaranteed to make trouble at Wentworth, it's your being made deputy governor again, Joan.
And why is that, Mrs. Powell?
Because you are the most deceitful, overbearing officer I've ever come across. You don't give a damn about these women or anybody, and you show it with every move you make.
Well, certainly took you a long time to get that off your chest, didn't it? Why the sudden revelation?
Well, I believe that officers should at least appear to pull together. However, you've made that job very difficult.
Well, some of us can take it, some of us can't.
I wouldn't be so smug if I was you. Sure, the department made the mistake of making you deputy once before. They wouldn't be so stupid as to do it again.
Well, I think it's all very sad after all our petitions and everything. Huh.
The trouble is, Pixie, government officials only see the words on the paper. You ask them to bend those words a little bit to suit someone in trouble. Oh, no, that won't be in their book.
We've all had a taste of that at one time or another.
But Hannah's so frightened.
I never thought she might be putting it on so she can stay.
Yeah. Wogs always get treated better than we do.
Oh.
I reckon she thought she was onto a good thing.
Your sort make me sick, Weasel. There's plenty of you around.
All working hard, are we?
Oh, we always work hard, Miss Ferguson.
Not always, Bryant. But you will be from now on. Because there'll be no slacking off when I'm deputy governor again.
Oh, hadn't you heard that Mrs. Powell had resigned? We'd heard the rumour, but we didn't know they'd settled on a replacement. Oh, they haven't. But it will be me, Desmond. Because they need someone who can keep you lot in line. Now, they wouldn't want a gutless deputy, would they?
Miss Ferguson, have you heard how Bobby is?
Oh, just that they're doing more tests, Parker. But I believe she's very sick. Very sick indeed. But then it's hardly surprising, is it? Come on, Desmond, you got a visitor.
Bitch.
Gosh, it doesn't sound like flu, does it?
Looks like you managed to do some damage after all, Carl.
Will you shut up, Red?
Just stating the obvious.
Oh, she's right. Don't reckon Bobby will ever get over what I've done. Now, that's not true, Cass. I mean, how do you know that Bobby doesn't really have the flu? Anyway, since when do we ever stop believing anything the freak says?
Kay. Hi, Mom.
All right, love, you look sick.
I'm all right.
You look like you haven't slept for a week.
I'm fine, Mum, honest.
Kay, love, you haven't been taking drugs again, have you?
Look, I've just been dieting, that's all. Not doing much good, though. I think I'll give it away. You don't look too good yourself.
Oh, yeah, I fell over. Kay, where are you living, love? Alan and I have been worried sick.
Well, that's what I've come for. To tell you I'm okay. I don't want you to worry.
Please, love, keep in contact with Alan. He cares about you too, you know.
I couldn't. I can't. Oh, I don't know. I can't talk to Alan, Mum. Not about anything personal. He just wouldn't understand.
Of course he would, Kay.
Anyway, I know how he feels about what I did to you. I don't know why I did it, Mum. I thought Gloria was... I don't know. I love you. That's what I've come to tell you.
I know you do. I've never doubted that for a second.
I wish you were back home. I miss you. There's no one else I can talk to.
Okay, love, if you're in some sort of trouble, please tell me. I want to help you.
It's just... sometimes I need to talk to you and you're not there. I'll be all right. Got to grow up sometime.
Love, go home with Alan. At least that way I'll know you're being looked after. God's sake, Kay, please.
Time's up.
You come and see me again soon, eh?
Didn't you hear me, Desmond?
I love you, Mum.
I love you too. You come and see me again, you promise, and look after yourself.
Blood samples and urine samples and who knows what, and they still haven't told me what's wrong with me.
Well, at least it's not catching.
Hmm? Where's Pigs?
Oh, she had to go and make a phone call. I'll tell you about it later.
But you're feeling well now?
Oh, I'm not sure anymore. I'm so full of needle holes.
They give you medicine?
Oh, yeah, tonics and vitamins and shots in the bum. I suppose I feel better than I did, though.
You know, there's someone here who would really like to welcome you back.
Yeah, I know.
Come on, Bobby. She's been worried sick about you. You know she tried to...
Well, yeah, look, I know all about that. I'm sorry. I'm just not up to it. This whole thing's really freaked me out.
Oh, hi, Bobby.
Hi.
Oh, how's Alan?
It's Kay.
Myra, what's wrong?
I don't know, Jude. She's sick. Something she wouldn't say. Oh, Jude, I don't even know where she's living. I rang Alan. All I did was start him worrying. There's nothing I can do. Not a single bloody thing.
Tonight?
Well, I've got a feeling if we leave it any longer, she'll be halfway to Europe. Can you come?
Oh, yes. But what's more to the point is, what can I do to help?
I'm having all the food and drinks delivered, so all you have to do is arrive and enjoy it.
Well, that's organisation. Now, what about a going-away present?
That I was leaving to you. What do you think she'd like?
Well, something for a trip. A nice piece of hand luggage, eh?
Perfect. Would you mind shopping for it, and then we can fix you tomorrow?
Fine.
You know I'll be needing a new deputy.
Yes, I suppose you will.
I was hoping you'd be applying.
There'll be a lot of other applications.
no one else from Wentworth with your seniority. Joan's already applied.
She didn't waste any time, did she?
No, she certainly didn't. You'd have my full support if you did apply. You'd also be doing Wentworth a favour and me.
All right. I'll think about it.
Good. I don't want to pressure you, but with Joan champing at the betters.
Oh, well, here she is, the woman of the moment.
Not the only one, though.
What now?
Mitchell's medical report.
I don't know about the fake, Jude. I never was much good with my hands.
Now, that's a lie. You told me you used to do some tie-dyeing.
Yeah, but the dye gets under your nails. It takes ages to get it out. Looks like my hands are in mourning.
Yeah, well, use rubber gloves next time.
I was making many things like that when I was a little girl. I want help, but I not be here.
Oh, well, never mind. You might be here next year.
I don't think so.
Mitchell, oh, you want...
Oh, just come with me.
Come on.
Might be your test results, eh?
Yeah.
Now, where have you been?
Mm-hmm. I thought you got caught.
Oh, no, I was much too clever. Mrs. Barry didn't even check the phone number.
What'd you do?
Well, I asked her about a wedding day, and she prattled on so much she even forgot the reason I was there. I'm going to sit with Cash. Doesn't look pretty.
Oh, all right. Myra, listen, I've been thinking, why don't you get Wally to help you with your daughter?
Oh, no, I doubt it, Jude. I mean, she won't even talk to Alan. I can't see her pouring her soul out to a total stranger.
It's worth a try, isn't it?
I don't know, Jude. It's me she needs. Hey, you're very lucky it was me that saw that, not the freak. Must be getting ideas from Cass. Put it back, Alan.
I have no reason to leave, Myra.
Listen to me. You could have been dead a dozen times by now. In the camps, crossing the border. You could have been picked up with your husband. Hannah, it has got to mean something. You're a survivor. You've come this far. You cannot give up now.
I'm not going to die or anything, am I?
Quite the opposite, in fact. You're going to have a baby.
But I can't be.
There's no doubt about it, Bobby. You're approximately 8 weeks pregnant.
Bloody hell.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.